Welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on locking and unlocking data in financial consolidation and closed cloud. After data for an entity has been reviewed and approved for a scenario year and period, you can lock the data. Locking prevents any modification to the data except by service administrators. To lock or unlock data, you must have the service administrator or power user role, and you must be the currently assigned owner of the entity or a member of a group that is the owner. You can lock data for entities only if their approval status for the selected scenario, year, and period is unlocked. You cannot lock entities with an approval status of not started. The calculation status of the entity must be OK, system change, or no data. You cannot lock an entity with impacted calculation status. You lock data from the approvals page. I'll lock actual data for February 2016. The Approvals page displays all entities with an approval status of unlocked or locked for the selected scenario, year, and period. I can select a sort order from the Sort By list. Click an entity to change its status. I'll lock data for USA sales. You can enter an annotation in the annotation box. When you lock a parent entity, the data for its descendants are locked also. You can lock data for a period only if all prior periods are locked. You can also unlock an entity, but only if all future periods for the entity are unlocked. For example, if March is locked, I cannot unlock February. I'll unlock the Pennsylvania entity. When you unlock a child entity, its parent is unlocked also. When unlocking a parent entity, select Unlock to unlock its descendants as well, or Unlock Single to unlock only the parent. I'll unlock West Sales using Unlock Single. West Sales status is unlocked while its children remain locked. In this tutorial, you learned how to lock and unlock data in financial consolidation and closed cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.